Hello, today I'm going to talk about the impurity control during API development. My name is Perry Fan. I've been working at Regis for about 5 years. Prior to Regis, I worked at the big pharma company for 20 years. Before I start, let me introduce Regis Technologies. Regis is a small molecule custom development and manufacture organization, CDMO. Regis serves clients from emerging pharma up to established big pharma companies. Regis has the process chemistry, analytical chemistry, and the chemical manufacture teams supporting API development and manufacture. Okay, back to the topic. Impurity control is a critical aspect of the API development process. The level of impurity in a drug substance or drug product may have a significant impact on the safety of consumers, that is the patients who are using it to fight their illness. There are three classes of impurities: organic impurities, which is a process, and drug related. Inorganic impurities, which are the reagents, ligands, catalysts, inorganic salts, heavy metals, or other residual metals, and other materials such as filter ads and the charcoals. Also, residual solvents, that are the solvents used during steps of API manufacturing. Impurities are discovered, measured, and using qualified and validated analytical method and reported within the batch record. If an impurity, the level is higher than the identification level defined by the ICH guidance Q3A, the structure of the impurity should be identified. As well, if the impurity level is higher than the qualification level defined by the Q3A, it should be qualified through biological safety studies. As we know, impurity control activities occur during all phases of drug development. At Regis, we worked on different projects at different phase of the drug development. We find out controlling impurities during early phases of development has a greater advantage than delayed in later phases. The early identification of impurities save time and money. Spending some money early will have a positive impact on the overall cost and the time of the drug development project. With the intention of early controlling impurities, we can use a database such as ACD Labs, the Numinata software, to monitor impurity fade and purge. All analytical data can be summarized together in a single place. The impurity history throughout the drug development and can be tracked and evaluated. We will understand the mechanism of impurity formation early by knowing the structure of impurities. If the impurity is related to raw materials, we can find a different raw material supplier with a different impurity profile. In this way, it is much cheaper than remove the impurity by some specific procedures. Also, if the impurity is a process related, we may modify the synthetic process or apply isolation steps to reduce or remove the impurities. Impurity identification can be done standalone by a company with a certain analytical capacity, but we realize identifying and managing impurity together with developing and manufacturing the API within your CDMO works much better. The analytical department at your CDMO has the full knowledge of API analytical results, history, and the trend of impurities in different batches. So the impurities are first discovered on the chromatograms of a final API analysis. Then based on the level of impurities, they will be selected for structure identification or qualification. When performing impurity structure identification with the impurity of a process chemist, with the input of a process chemist, we can narrow down possibilities of impurity structures based on the synthetic reactions. Because CDMO has access to starting materials, intermediate, mother liquors, and the byproducts, which will significantly assist the effort of impurity structure identification. If needed, also CDMO has the capacity to isolate or synthesize quantity of impurities for analytical reference purpose or supply of impurity qualification studies. So finally, within a CDMO organizations, teams of analytical chemists and the process chemists are typically working together at the same location. So the team works between the process chemist and analytical chemist is the fastest and least expensive way to control of your impurities. At the work, analytical development discuss impurities with the process chemist. The discussion including analytical results of an API batch, possible structure of impurities, batch performance with the trend of impurity profile, etc. The back from the process chemistry with the information of analytical chemist, process chemist, can adjust their synthetic route or apply isolations to reduce the impurity level. So the results of impurity identification will feed back to the sourcing to find appropriate qualified the suppliers during the development as well. That means if needed, just by switching the raw material or starting material supply, we can reduce the impurity level significantly and easily. Overall, manage and identify impurities early and working together as a team between process chemistry and analytical chemistry will save time and money to your API development project. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website at www.registech.com.